Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new tutorial video. Today I will talk about enum mappings with JPA and Hibernate. But first things first, if this is your first time here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. And if you have any relevant topic that you want me to cover on this channel and in my blog, let me know in the comments below. Most developers use enums in their domain models. You can easily map them with Hibernate. They provide a strongly typed way to model an attribute that has one out of a list of defined values. The format of a book is a typical example of such an enum. Supported values could be hardcover, paperback, and ebook. With JPA and Hibernate, you can map enums in different ways. You can use the standard mappings to a number or a string, create a customized mapping to a basic type supported by Hibernate, or define a custom mapping to a database-specific type like PostgreSQL's enum type. In this video, I will show you how to use all three of these options to map the rating enum you can see in this piece of code here. It's used in the review entity to represent the rating of a book. Enums are a first-class citizen of the Java language and used in most domain models. So it's no surprise that JPA and Hibernate provide a standard mapping for them. You can choose between two mappings. By default, Hibernate maps an enum to a number. It uses the ordinal value, which is the zero base position of a value within the definition of the enum. So the enum value that's defined first gets mapped to 0, the second one to 1, and so on. This mapping is very efficient, but there is a high risk that adding or removing a value from your enum will change the ordinal values of the remaining values. You don't need to annotate your entity attribute if you want to store the ordinal value of your enum in the database. Here you can see an example of such a mapping. Rating is an enum that represents the rating you want to give to a certain book. As you can see, I didn't annotate the attribute with any annotation. Hibernate then maps the rating attribute to an integer. You can also map the enum value to a string. This mapping is not as efficient, but you can add or remove enum values without any side effects. You just can't rename a value without migrating your database. If you want to persist the string representation of your enum value, you need to annotate your entity attribute with enumerated and set the enum type to string. When you take a look at the database, you can see that Hibernate now persisted the name of the enum value. The two previously shown standard mappings are good enough for most domain models, but they can make a refactoring of your persistence layer harder than it should be. They are also not flexible enough to handle the mapping used by most legacy data models. In all these situations, a custom mapping to a string or a number is the better choice. It gives you the flexibility to implement the mapping used in your legacy database. You can handle the changes in your mapping instead of migrating the database if you need to refactor your enum. Creating a custom mapping is straightforward. You implement the attribute converter interface, annotate the class with @converter, and implement the two methods that provide the mapping between the entity and the database representation. If you want to use the converter for all attributes of type rating automatically, you can set the auto-apply attribute of the converter annotation to true. In this example, I map the rating enum to an integer. This mapping is very similar to the mapping as an ordinal value, but this one is easier to read and you don't need to worry about any refactorings. Hibernate's ordinal mapping would map rating 1 to its ordinal value 0, rating 2 to the ordinal value 1, and so on. By using the rating converter, we get the more intuitive mapping of rating 1 to 1, rating 2 to 2, and so on. But before you try to use this mapping, you need to put the right annotations on your entity attribute. You can't use an attribute converter on an entity attribute that's annotated with enumerated. So you need to remove that annotation from your mapping if you want to use the custom mapping. If you didn't annotate your converter with converter and outer apply true, you also need to annotate the entity attribute with a convert annotation and provide the rating attribute converter class as the value of the converter attribute. This tells Hibernate to use the reference converter when it reads or writes this entity attribute. Hibernate applies the converter transparently whenever you use the review entity and its rating attribute in your business code, a JPQL or criteria query. So you can use the rating attribute in the same way as any other entity attribute. Some databases, like PostgreSQL, offer custom data types to store enumerations. These data types are similar to the enum type that we know in Java. They define a set of valid values that can be stored in the database column, like you see in this code here. In the code, I use PostgreSQL's enum type, but you can use the same approach to support similar types supported by other DBMS. Unfortunately, you can't use Hibernate's default mapping to map your Java enum to a PostgreSQL enum. As explained earlier, Hibernate maps the enum values to an int or a string, but PostgreSQL expects you to set the value as an object. If you want to map your enum to PostgreSQL's enum type, you need to implement a custom mapping. But don't worry, if you extend Hibernate's enum type, you just need to override one method to set the value as an object. That only requires 4 lines of code, and to make it even better, you can use your custom type to map any Java enum to a PostgreSQL enum. So you can use this type for all enums in your project, and you can even add it to one of your internal libraries. Let's have a look how you use custom types. You can use the custom type in your entity mappings in 2 ways. You can reference the class of your enum type in a type annotation on your entity attribute. This is a good approach if you only use the type on one entity attribute. When you use this mapping, Hibernate uses the enum type PostgreSQL to map the rating value to a PostgreSQL specific enum type. If you use the type to map multiple entity attributes, you should register your type using a typedef annotation. You can either add the annotation to one of your entities or put it into a package-info.java file. After you've done that, you can reference the type by its logical name in your entity mapping. With Hibernate, you can map enums in 3 ways. Hibernate's standard mappings provide a simple way to store enum values in your database. You can choose if you want to persist the string representation of your enum value or if you prefer its ordinal value. The string representation is more robust, while the ordinal value is more efficient. If you need to map a legacy database or if you prefer mapping that you can easily refactor, you should implement your own mapping using an attribute converter. JPA and Hibernate don't support any database-specific enum types. If you want to use them in your table model, you need to implement your own enum type by extending Hibernate's enum type. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!